make the ground shake.
Hello YouTube, this is Fairy Tale Chapter 485 review, and this chapter was pretty good, and I just like how at the end, Dajio got so mad at Bradman. He's like, you brought up the worst memories of my life, and I am going to destroy you. And what he meant by the worst memories of his life is he meant what he did to Levi back in the Phantom Lord arc. So, yeah, Dajio's pissed. He's gonna do something next chapter. So, the beginning of this chapter, we start off with Natsu, Lucy, Happy, and Brandish. They're talking about August and how they're going to negotiate while they're on their way to talk to August. And Brandish mentions that August is very dedicated to Xerath. And I forget which one of them says it. It was either Natsu or Lucy. It might have been Happy. And they said, then, how are we going to convince him not to attack us? And basically, Brandish is like, I don't know. She's like, oh crap, I didn't think of that. That's what Brandish said. And Brandish also said that if Natsu picked a fight with August, that he would obliterate Natsu, which we kind of already knew that, but who knows, you know, maybe Natsu would actually put up a fight. We don't know. I don't really think that August is going to go against Natsu. Honestly, I see August going against Gildarts or Makarov. And that's just my opinion, but I'd say a lot of people probably agree on that matchup. Tell me if you agree with that matchup in the comments below. Also, Mest, he was hiding, he was following them, and he's like, you know how he doesn't trust Brandish and stuff? He's like, I still don't trust her. Now, what I thought was really cool, and I would like to see used more often, was Brandish made, I wanted to say Luffy, I don't know why I wanted to say Luffy, but Happy. Brandish made Happy so freaking big, like she made him a giant, and I thought it was like just Happy's powers on his own, but no, it was actually Brandish's magic, because I for a minute I forgot about Brandish's magic. I was like, holy crap, Happy actually did something, but I realized, oh, it was Brandish's magic. So that was a little bit disappointment there, but not too much, but definitely I want to see this happen in the future more, like Brandish doing something, because honestly, I see Brandish becoming a good guy. I know Brandish, she says that she isn't going to, you know, help and stuff, but I still see her, like, eventually, you know, giving into Fairy Tail and becoming a ally or a member of Fairy Tail. I don't know. I think a lot of people see that as well, so, I mean, you never know. But then it switches over to where Kana was trying to bring back the actual Mavis with her actual body, which I honestly completely forgot about, and I feel kind of like stupid for forgetting about that. Well, not really stupid, but you know what I mean. And basically, if you guys don't remember, Kana is supposed to attack Mavis's body, and so that Mavis can like get intact with her body or something like that. I don't really remember all the way, but it's something on the lines of that. I know she has to attack that crystal or Luminous Dore, and that's going to like bring like her body and her like spirit into one or something like that. Or it may be like destroying Mavis completely. I forgot, honestly. One thing that I thought was cool was how Mavis was relating Kana to Zera, almost said Xerath. But Zera, if you guys don't know who Zera is, that is Mavis's friend, or imaginary friend. It wasn't her imaginary friend, it was a real person, but when Mavis was growing up on Tenro Island, that friend died, but as we know, Mavis's actual magic is to like bring up images or illusions, and that's what Zera was. She was an illusion that Mavis created after the real Zera died. So I thought that was pretty cool how Mavis was relating Kana to her friend, but then she said, okay, well, never mind. It was really just a hair, but if you think about it, they kind of are not related. I'm not saying they're related, but they kind of do look alike. They may be related. Who knows? I don't think they're related, though. Then actually, we go back to where Gaju and Sabretooth and Blue Pegasus are, and basically, Sabretooth is getting back up after they were on the crosses or being crucified or whatever you want to call it, and Sting, he feels so terrible, because he feels like a terrible good master, but of course, Yukino slapped some sense into him, so I thought that was pretty cool as well. And I just like how they're getting up and they're getting encouraged. I don't think that Sabretooth or Blue Pegasus is really going to do a lot to like this friggin' 12, but they may do some to some of the Alvarez kingdoms, like many guys, like soldiers. So what I really want to see is next chapter that I mentioned at the beginning of this review was Gaggio versus Bradman, and Gaggio is pissed, and I can't wait to see this fight happen. And it seems like next chapter is called The Fourth Guest, so I'm guessing there's going to be another Spriggan 12 showing up. So who could it be? There are apparently three on the battlefield right now. Well, obviously I said the fourth guest, so I'm guessing the fourth guest will be August, but I may be wrong because I don't know where August is exactly at, and I'm pretty sure August is with other Spriggan 12, or at least one. I know God's Arena was taken down, so God's Arena is out, unless like August has some like healing magic and healed God's Arena or something. Or maybe it's Agnologia. I never thought of Agnologia. So maybe it's that. Tell me who you think the fourth guest is. Tell me what you thought of this chapter. I'm going to rate this chapter 7 out of 10. Chapter was pretty good. I can't wait for the next chapter because, Gaggio is just going to go all out on Bradman. And it's going to be a great fight. I have a feeling I can already tell about how mad Gaggio is. I mean, when Gaggio's mad, he is going to go crazy. So, anyways, guys, tell me what you thought of this chapter in the comments below. Leave a like if you enjoyed this review, and subscribe. Anyways, guys, have a nice day. I'm out.